How do you search for life on other planets? Follow the water. Hi everyone, I'm Amy Shira Teitel and I'm guest hosting for DNews. If you're among the living, you have something in common with every other life form on the planet. You need water to live. So it would make sense that if you find the substance necessary for life on Earth elsewhere, it increases your chances of finding extraterrestrial life. Now, we've never found liquid water on Mars, so it's probably not the best place to be looking, right? We should be focusing our energies on the subsurface oceans on Titan and Europa, shouldn't we? Well, maybe not. A new study from a team at the University of Michigan has found a way for liquid water to exist on the surface of Mars, and the key is salt. We've been exploring Mars with orbiters, landers, and rovers since the mid-1960s, and most of what we've found where water is concerned is evidence that ancient Mars was wet. We've found weathered rocks indicative of ancient rivers, photographs of gullies flowing down crater rims, and chemical signatures in rocks that can only have formed in the presence of water. But in 1998, we got an interesting break in the form of pictures from NASA's Phoenix lander. Some showed ice in trenches left by the lander's scoop, and others showed globules on the lander's legs. These globules caught scientists' eyes because they not only persisted in later images, they seemed to get bigger. It was clear that something was happening on Mars. Could it be that water droplets were somehow pooling on the lander's legs? The obvious problem in thinking the globules were water is Mars's environment. Being further from the sun than the Earth, with a much thinner atmosphere, the red planet is cold. The average surface temperature is about 80 degrees below zero Fahrenheit. This is where the salt comes in. Just like how salt melts ice on the roads in winter, salt in Martian soil could melt subsurface ice. It's possible that the Phoenix lander blasted away enough topsoil to expose the necessary salts and subsurface ice for the two to interact and form liquid water, water that then froze on the lander's legs. Which means the same thing could be happening elsewhere on Mars without the facilitating effects of a lander exposing the materials. The key is the salt content in Mars's soil. The Phoenix lander and the Curiosity rover have both detected calcium perchlorate on Mars, a salty mixture of calcium, chlorine, and oxygen that is also found in arid places on Earth, like in the Atacama Desert in Chile. To test whether this salt could form water simply through contact with ice, the University of Michigan team recreated Phoenix's landing site in late spring, early summer environment in a laboratory. In one of these duplicate Mars environments, the team put millimeter-thick layers of salt on temperature-controlled plate of Mars-like soil, and nothing happened. But in the other duplicate Mars environment, the team put calcium perchlorate directly on a 3 millimeter thick layer of ice and watched as drops of water formed within minutes, even with the chamber set at minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit. From these lab results, the team concluded that small amounts of liquid water could exist on Mars's surface, specifically in the shallow areas between the polar regions and mid-latitudes during the daytime hours of the warmer spring and summer seasons. It's a natural cycle that might explain how gullies flow, freeze, and thaw before flowing again, and it also might explain how it is that water has been able to form just below the Martian surface, which might itself be a compelling way to look for life. We've seen frozen saltwater lattices playing host to microbial life on Earth, so the same thing could be happening on Mars. So do you think we should dig deeper into the Martian soil to see if there's life underneath? Tell us in the comments below and keep checking back here for more DNews.